children. Today we will look at the Seven Sea Journeys story of the sea supremo Sindbad. One day Sindbad was sitting in his palace like usual and smoking hookah. He was a little restless today because his servant Hindbad wasn't concentrating on his work, and this was noticed by Sindbad. And so Sindbad had called him in his palace.
Sir, did you call me?
Yes, Hindbad. I have noticed for some time that you are not concentrating on your work. Do you have any problems, Hindbad?
Nothing, sir.
Look, don't fear. Tell me about whatever problems you have. I will help you.
Sir, I am having a question in my mind for many days.
Speak up.
My name is Hindbad and you're Sindbad.
Hmm.
There is only a little difference in our names. But you are enjoying a lavish life and I am only doing mere sweeping work. You are really very lucky, sir.
Come on, Hindbad, what do you want to say? This wealth, this grandeur, I've earned by just sitting at home. No, Hindbad, I did not get this grandeur so easily. For this, I have had to face many troubles and dangers. Come and sit here. I will tell you today the story of my journey across the seven seas. It was my first day of the sea journey.
How beautiful the sea looks! Bluish, exactly like the sky. As if the water is the reflection of the sky. Yes.
Hey, what's the name before?
Maybe somebody you know. Yes, I do think the sea.
Mr. Kasir.
Ah.
I think there is a new businessman today on the ship.
Ah.
Looks handsome like a prince.
Yes, Brother Suleiman. This is his first journey. His name is Sindbad. As you say, he could live the royal life of a prince. So much wealth was left behind by his father. But after his father's death, he fell in a bad company of friends and blew all away the wealth doing all sorts of vices. All the friends left him soon after his money was over. Then his eyes were open. And therefore, selling the last piece of land he had, he has bought some goods and is out with us for business.
Oh, no. What a bad phase of life he is going through.
Brother, there's a saying, you reap as you sow. What else?
Yes, this is also true, brother.
So Sindbad, you seem to be very happy.
Yes, Captain. I'm looking at the sea so closely for the first time. Blue sky on top, vast blue sea in front, and only the melodious sounds of the waves and the wind can be heard from all four directions. I just don't feel like moving from here, Captain.
You are mad. Initially, one does fall in love with blue color. But as the time passes, you become restless to be on the firm ground. You too will experience what I say.
There is a saying that novelty is till it's new. The same way, within a few days, Sindbad too was fed up with all this. Even he started feeling restless like the others. He was impatient to step on ground.
What's that? Oh my! Hey! Come here!
What happened?
Look there! I can see a small island!
What is it?
Yeah, there! Straight in front! Can you see that? Yes! It is an island!
Island! It's an island!
Hey, Captain!
Yes!
Look! You can see an island there!
An island?
Yeah, a beautiful island! I'm so restless to be there on the island.
Come on, Captain.
Why don't you come too?
Come, Captain.
Come.
Be careful. Wow. The island is so beautiful.
Yes. I saw the land after so many days. This is a very nice feeling. Everybody is so happy. Huh? Hey, what is this happening? Why is this ground shaking? Hey,
come on, run! Come back to the ship fast! This is not an island! This is the back of a very huge tortoise! Come fast! Come fast to the ship!
Yes, fast!
Oh my god! What happened? Why my leg is not moving? What happened? Oh my! Who's pulling me? Leave me! Leave me! Leave my leg! Who's this? Who's pulling me? What's this? No! Leave me! I say leave my leg! You did not hear me? Oh, okay. Now what is this? Ya Allah, please help me! Please help me! Leave me! Okay, wait. I will teach you a good lesson. Just see. Yes. And wait. I will show you now. Take this. Where's the ship gone? Now if this tortoise goes in the water, what about me? Khuda, now to kill me or to save me, it's all in your hands, Khuda.
And thus, depending totally on the Almighty, Sindbad himself didn't know when he fell asleep on the wooden log he had clung to.
What's this? Am I dreaming? No. This is an island, in fact. Ya Allah. Thank you. There is no way at all to go up. Yes, I think this creeper will help me to go up. Ya Allah. I'm thirsty and my throat is dry. First, I should look out for water. That's important. It's good. There is a stream nearby. Now I feel somewhat better. What's this? Very good. A horse grazing over there. It means there must be people staying nearby. Yes. I must find for something to eat. Let's hope.
Sindbad was staggering due to hunger. He came to that horse. But he could see nobody around. Sindbad was little afraid when he saw two soldiers running towards him with swords in their hands.
Hey! Who are you? And what are you doing here?
My name is Sindbad. I am a businessman.
Listening to the difficulties Sindbad had gone through, the soldiers felt pity for him and they gave him something to eat from their share.
Sindbad, you are so lucky that you met us on this island. There, can you see there? This is the pet horse of our king Marriage. The cure for the sickness of this horse is found only in the medicinal plants of this island.
And therefore, we bring this horse on this lonely island once in a year. We will be going tomorrow. You two come with us. You meet our king. He is a very kind-hearted person.
Sindbad started journey with them the next day. After some days, they reached the capital. The king ordered for the lodging boarding arrangements of Sindbad. Capital of King Mirhez was a seaport. And so Sindbad went to the port for a stroll daily. Suddenly one day, he saw his own ship.
Yes!
Oh,
yes.
Brother! Come on, lift him!
Carefully.
Lift carefully!
Lift carefully!
Come on, be fast! Be quick!
Captain! Captain?
Huh?
Did you recognize me? Who? I'm Sindbad.
Sindbad?
Even my goods are there on your ship.
Oh, Sindbad!
Yes!
You are alive!
Yes, yes, Captain.
We thought you were drowned!
Sindbad told everything to the captain.
Sindbad, I am very happy from my heart on seeing you.
Thank you, Captain.
Sindbad sold a very good volume of goods in that market and presented some things to King Mirhez for the help done. Then, doing good business in different places, the ship reached the city of Baghdad.
And in this way, I acquired a lot of wealth by doing business in the very first journey and built a small house and lived very happily.
Sir, The happenings of your first journey are really amazing.
Then now listen to the story of my second journey. I had earned a lot of wealth from the first journey. Therefore, now I had decided to take rest, but I started feeling uneasy within few days. And so, I got out for business again. On seeing a port, we would stop and sell some goods. Thus, our journey started. One fine day, our ship reached near an island full of greenery.
Wow! How pretty these colorful flowers are! They are spread on the entire island! And these attractive butterflies flying on them!
You are right. And the fruits on the trees are also very attractive, isn't it? First, let's eat something.
Yes, come.
Listen, don't go too far. We should start within an hour.
Yes. Just I will go to the trees and come back.
Okay. And bring some fruit for me too.
I'll see.
What?
I'm bringing.
All the merchants went to the fruit trees and Sindbad reached very far enjoying seeing colorful flowers. And then sat in order to rest for a while. He himself didn't realize when he was fast asleep sitting under the tree.
What's this? Why can't I move my hands and legs? What's happening? Yalla! Such a big spider! What should I do? Get out, I say! Don't come near me! Just one kick has softened him. Oh, this one is back with a bigger spider. Now what to do? Yalla, He's coming towards me. Oh, what should I do? What should I do? Wait. Wait, why are you running now? Wait!
Sindbad succeeded in freeing himself from the clutches of that spider. But because the ship had already gone, he got left behind on the island. He climbed on a very tall tree to see if there was any mankind in the vicinity. He could see some white thing very far.
What is that? I should go and see it. What is this? If this is supposed to be a building, then why can't I see any doors and windows in it? What is it exactly? Ya Allah! This bird is so big and huge! And why is it coming towards me? Is it looking at me as its prey? Ya Allah! What to do? I should hide somewhere. Yes. But where? Yes. I should hide under this thing. Yes. I hope it does not see me. Ya Allah, please save me. Please help me. Ya Khuda, this means the white thing I thought to be a building is an egg of that bird. It was wise of me to hide at the right time. How huge is this bird? It surely must be a kite or an eagle. Ya Allah, it's so hot inside.
After sitting on the egg for some time, that bird flew away in the sky. It didn't even know that Sindbad was hanging by its feet. But suddenly it became aware and then it started attacking with its beak.
Ya Khuda, please help. Ya Khuda, this looks like a deep valley. This is like jumping out of the frying pan and falling into the fire. What should I do now? What's shining here? Is it a diamond? What's this? This place is full of diamonds. Yes. Wow. I'm rich man now. Yes. I'm a rich man now. Ya Allah. What's this? This place is very dangerous. How dreadful these snakes are. What to do? Piece of meat? That means someone is up there! Please help! Help me! Pull me up! Pull the rope up! Fast! Please! Please! Quickly! Pull me up!
Come on!
Pull!
Don't leave me!
Yes! You have saved my life by throwing that piece of meat. Take this. These diamonds I have brought for you.
So many diamonds?
Yes, take.
No, brother, no. I usually get 4 to 5 diamonds. I will only take that much.
Seeing the honesty of the merchant, Sindbad was highly impressed and respected him. All the merchants collected the diamonds for them, and Sindbad too was ready for his back journey with them.
And in this way, I was out of that danger. I earned unimaginable wealth in this second journey. I started living very happily. But within few days, I became bored of sitting at home. And therefore, I was out on my third sea journey.
Sindbad spent some initial days very happily. But one day, there was a great hustle in the sea, which was so calm till today.
Has made its way through storms bigger than this. You all please don't worry.
After some time, the ship, carried away by the waves of the sea, reached an island.
We are on an island. We are safe now.
No.
Huh?
On the contrary, now we are in danger.
What?
This is a mountain named Udwa. Hairy creatures like monkeys stay here. There is no chance to remain alive from their hands.
What? Ya Allah! Look at them! They are coming towards us!
Sindbad, they are too many in number. We can't tackle them, Sindbad.
Now, because the ship and the goods were ransacked, all the people were sad and were trying to find a safe place to stay.
Friends, look there. I think there is a fort.
Yes.
There's surely some people must be staying.
Yes.
Let's go. But we have to be careful.
That's fine.
All reached inside the fort, a little scared.
What is this happening? Why is this land shaking? Is there an earthquake? Is there an earthquake?
Who's laughing?
Human creature.
Monster.
After so many days, I've again got humans to eat. Now I will eat you one by one.
Hey monster, where am I?
Come on.
We'll have to get out of this island making a raft as quick as possible.
All were tired now, rowing the raft. And therefore, in order to take rest, everybody lay down on the raft and soon fell asleep. When they opened their eyes, the raft had reached some other island.
What is this?
Ya Allah, this is really a huge python.
Sindbad,
no doubt we came out of that monster's trap. It is difficult to escape from here. One by one, this python has swallowed our two friends. Are we really safe here completely? Do you think so?
Of course. You please don't worry now. Because I'm supposed to worry now. I'm completely safe in this cage of thorns. Come and eat me now, so that these thorns will pierce your throat nicely. Come.
Khuda, please save me from this difficulty.
Sindbad was really lucky enough because a merchant ship was passing from there within 2 days.
You are like a messenger of Khuda to me. I am really thankful to you for allowing me to get onto your ship.
Okay, that's all right. But tell me, who are you and what are you doing here?
The captain was astonished, listening to Sindbad's whole story.
Yes, you are really very lucky, son, that you are still alive in spite of so many dangers. Now don't worry at all. I have some goods on my ship. The owner is missing. I am giving those goods to you. You do the business and earn money and go home happily.
And in this way, because of that kind-hearted captain, I could come home safely earning much money.
Sir? Only by listening to whatever you say, I am so frightened that I am shivering to death.
Hindbad, 4 of my journeys are still remaining. Do you want to listen to those or not?
Please continue, sir. I am anxious to listen to your further adventures.
As usual, the initial days of the 4th journey too passed happily. But one day, there was heavy stormy wind, dark clouds gathered over the sky, and the ship started bouncing on the sea waves. Finally, it broke, completely dashing against a rock.
It's so sad. Most of my companions passed away in this storm.
Ya Khuda, those who are dead, may their souls rest in peace.
Look, I can see some huts far away.
What are you saying?
Yes, I am telling the truth.
Huts are there, so human beings must be there.
Yes, come on. You had said there will be human beings too. Never said black people will be there.
Shut up.
Welcome. Welcome.
Come over.
Of these people seem to be suspicious. Nobody amongst them is eating the leaves given to us.
Huh?
And Sindbad's doubt was true. The leaves they were given were intoxicating and hunger-raising. In order that nobody should suspect, Sindbad was making gestures exactly like his friends.
Now I understand everything. These are man-eaters. I think their plan is to make us healthy and eat up.
And the same thing happened as Sindbad had thought. Two of Sindbad's friends were roasted and eaten by them. He escaped from there somehow that very night. He was running continuously for 3 hours. He reached the sea coast after 10 days.
These people are working in the field. They will surely not be man-eaters.
Hey there, who are you? And where from are you coming?
My name is Sindbad. I'm a merchant. But unfortunately, me and my friends were fallen in the hands of the man-eaters. I have managed to run away from there.
What are you telling, brother?
Huh?
Nobody has escaped from the hands of those demons till today. Mm. You are the first. You come with me. I'll take you to our king.
Sindbad, you are here for the past 3 months. Till when can you live alone like this? Now I feel that you should get married.
As you wish.
The king got Sindbad married to a beautiful and rich girl within 2 days. Eat well, get entertained. It was a happy life Sindbad was leading. But one day, a friend of Sindbad came to see him.
Sindbad, I have come to take your leave.
But for what?
Friend, my wife passed away today in the morning.
Ya Allah, it's bad news.
No, something worse is going to happen with me now.
What do you want to say? I didn't get you.
There is a custom in our village that husband or wife, whosoever dies amongst the two, the one who remains alive is left with the dead body in a cave situated in the valley. And what they give is a single piece of bread and a jug full of water. That cave is closed with a stone. Friend, now we will never ever meet.
Sindbad was scared hearing this. Now he started taking good care of his wife. But the destiny could not be changed.
Ya Khuda, till date you have saved me from many dangers. Save me from this one too. Now what? It's so dark, can't see anything. But what is this shining here? The diamonds and pearls spread over the dead bodies? But of what use are they now? Khuda, is there no way to escape from here now? Arey, this seems to be a sea rat. But how did it come here? The way the rat came in must be the way to go out too. Yes!
Sindbad started digging the rat hole with the knife he had with him. Within 5 days, he could come out through that rat hole. He was very happy seeing the sea in front of him.
Now I have to wait for some ship to come. Before that, I should go and bring those pearls and diamonds. Thank you very much for allowing me to board the ship.
It's all right. But as soon as the next port comes, you get down and go wherever you want to go.
After thanking the captain of that ship, I got down on the next port and reached home on the next ship. I had brought many diamonds and pearls with me, which earned me much wealth.
Sir, there are so many dangers in the journeys, so why go? Did this thought never come to your mind?
Yes, it did come to my mind once. But if a person has to die, he can die sitting at home too. Thinking this, I again went on a journey after some days.
Captain, we didn't take a halt on the last island, but we must stop here, am I right?
Yes, yes, Hussain Mia, we will surely stop.
How nice you feel when you touch the ground, isn't it?
Of course. Come on, we'll stroll a little.
Oh, yes. Come on.
Come on.
Can Brothers, you see some fruits there? I'm very hungry.
Brothers, you all eat so much and still feel hungry. Instead of Kadar Mia, your name should have been Eater Mia.
Huh? Hey, look at that! Can you see something? Look at that!
Listen, better not go there. They are the eggs of a very huge bird. Those birds are very dangerous.
Sindbad, if you don't want to come, then don't come. Today is the big feast day for us. What friends?
Yes.
You're right.
Come on,
let's go.
Come on.
Hey, Sindbad, eat a little at least. You are scared of what? I'm there.
The merchants who had ignored Sinbad's warning and behaved foolishly had to pay for their deeds.
How did I come here? And what's this? Do you see any of my companions? That means I'm the only survivor from that accident. Ya khuda.
Thank God, there are at least fruits on this island. Now I think I should go out for one.
Sindbad searched in many places, And at last, he saw an old man sitting near the river.
Grandfather, since when are you on this island? Grandfather, are you lost too like me and have come on this island? I think you cannot speak, Grandfather. You want to go to the other side of that stream? Wait, I will lift you up. Grandfather, now please get down. We have reached the other side of the stream. Please get down. But what happened, Grandfather? Please get down. Why don't you get down? What are you doing, Grandfather? We both will fall. What happened? What happened? Why are you laughing? Why are you not getting down? What are you doing? Please don't do this. We both will fall.
And so, the old man sitting on Sinbad's back wasn't ready to get down at all. The whole day he forced Sinbad to carry him wherever he wanted to go. Otherwise, he was pulling Sinbad's hair, pressing his throat. Even during night time, when Sinbad was asleep, the old man remained sitting on his shoulders.
Oh, Grandfather, what are you doing? Please leave him. Don't pull my hair. Ya Allah, the stories I have been listening from the merchants, I think this is the same ghost who sits on the shoulders. Now it's difficult to get out of his clutches.
But one day suddenly, Sinbad found a solution.
This gourd like this, so that nice liquor will be ready within few days.
After some days, the liquor was ready as Sindbad wanted. The grip of the old man's legs around Sinbad's neck got loosened as he drank the liquor. Sinbad then straight away struck him down onto the ground and hit him with a very big stone on his head.
You have obliged me very much by taking me on your ship. I really thank you.
No need to thank me, brother. I had also heard that on that island there is a ghost who sits on the shoulders.
He isn't now. He was. I have finished him with my own hands.
What?
Yes.
Have you finished that ghost?
Yes.
Brother, you have really done a big favor on the travelers passing from here.
In which direction are you going?
We are coconut merchants, going to bring the coconuts.
Okay.
You two come with us, so that you too will get a chance to make money by selling coconuts. Hey!
Come on.
Captain, this method of yours is really interesting.
Oh yes, less efforts and more profits. We'll stay on this island for some days. I had collected many coconuts by that interesting method and earned a lot of wealth by selling coconuts on my way back. And after returning home, lived very happily. This time I had decided that I won't go on a journey again. But who can change what's written in your destiny? After some days, I did go for a journey buying goods for business, and our ship also got stuck in a storm like usual.
Captain! There are very big rocks in the sea! A ship can strike against any rock anytime and will be broken into pieces! We have to do something, Captain!
Yes,
we have to do something!
But what can we do?
Are there wooden boats on our ship?
Oh yes, there are!
Then we shall make a raft out of them! Come on, friends, come on! Join in to help!
Yes, come on, come on, come on! Come on, we'll help Sindbad!
So nice. Thank you, Khuda. You have saved us.
Sindbad, only because of you we are alive today.
It's not me. Our Khuda has saved our lives.
Yes.
But as I had told, I hope you all have taken the eatables and necessary things along.
Yes.
We have taken.
Now we should reach some good island and we will be safe.
We have come on such a bare island where no creature can remain alive.
This is a more difficult thing for us now.
Yes, Captain. You are absolutely correct. Now we will have to eat very carefully and save the eatables we have.
Yes, Sindbad, you are very correct.
As per Sindbad's warning, everybody was eating very little in order to survive. But within a month, as the eatables started getting over, all lost their lives one by one.
I'm also surely going to die within 3-4 days. I must look out for some other way. What is that? Till today I have seen many rivers coming from the mountains and meeting the sea. But this is the first river I have seen, which is coming from the banks of the sea and going somewhere towards the mountains. Instead of dying on this island, why not get flown with this water?
Sindbad remained awake for 2 days with his eyes wide open. But even he didn't realize when he was fast asleep. When he opened his eyes, he was outside a cave.
Black people! Are they man-eaters? Ya Allah, please have mercy.
Hey, who are you? How are you here?
First, you tell me, who are you?
We are farmers. You are in our kingdom, Serendip.
On listening to Sindbad's story, that farmer took him to his king.
Splendid, Sindbad. Interesting. Your story is very, very thrilling. I am fond of collecting such thrilling stories. If you don't have any objection, I would like to write down the whole story. Why not? Many strange and miraculous incidents have taken place in my life. I will tell you those too. Very good. Listen, he must be given comfortable hostage. And the royal writer must be given in his service.
After writing all the extraordinary incidents of Sindbad's life, on King Sarandeep's insistence, Sindbad even told everything about Baghdad.
Very good. Sindbad, from the information you have given, a great respect is formed in my heart for your Khalifa of Baghdad. I would like to present him something when you will be going back.
After some days, Sindbad was ready to go home. King Sarandeep honored him by presenting clothes and gave some valuable presents for the Khalifa of Baghdad. Sindbad reached Baghdad after few days.
Your Majesty, King Sarandeep is very kind-hearted. He respects and honors you very much. And therefore he has sent you these precious and valuable presents. This glass and the blue diamonds on it are incomparable. And if this snake skin is kept under the bed, you will never fall sick. And thus, handing over the presents given by King Sarandeep, I took leave of Khalifa and came home and started living happily, forgetting all the past troubles. My attraction for journeys was over now, and I was getting aged too. I had decided that I will never go on a journey now. But one fine day, Khalifa of Baghdad called me.
Sindbad, the last journey you did was a long time ago. You must have rested well by now. And therefore, I want you to do some work for me.
Please do a favor and don't ask me to go on any journey.
So, Sindbad, what are you thinking?
Nothing. May you please order your majesty?
Look, King Sarandeep presented me so many things. So some presents must be given to him also. That's what I feel.
If it's your order, I'll surely go. But I am growing old now. So it would be better if any youth is sent.
No, Sindbad. Where will I get an intelligent and an adventurous man like you? And above all, I trust you, Sindbad. And therefore, you go, please.
All right. I will make the preparations to go.
Sindbad started his journey with all the things given for King Sarandeep by Khalifa. He was safely in Sarandeep within few days.
My lord, I had thought that you won't recognize me at all.
Sindbad, who can ever forget a brave and heroic man like you? Now that you have come, please stay for a month with us.
No, my lord. I will have to go next week.
All right. As you wish. But when you reach Baghdad, may the Khalifa be thanked for this present on my behalf.
After a week, Sindbad was ready to go back. But one day, some sea pirates attacked his ship. Those who opposed were killed. And the rest were sold as slaves by the pirates. Sindbad was bought by a very rich man.
The behavior of the master with the slaves is that of animals. You must be well aware of this. But you don't worry, Sindbad. I am not a master of that type. Tell me one thing. Do you know how to hunt, Sindbad?
Well, I had done it when I was young. If I try, I can do it even today.
Very good. This was the type of slave I wanted. Sindbad, you sit on this tree. Elephants pass from here in the evening. Try to kill at least one of them and then come and tell me.
The master explained Sindbad and went away. In the evening, when some elephants were passing under the tree, Sindbad shot many arrows at them. One elephant was shot on right place and he fell down.
Master, I have
killed one elephant.
Very good. Splendid. Now for this I give you 2 mohras as a reward.
Master, why do you bury the elephant in this manner?
Sindbad, now in few days the elephant's body will decay. Then we'll remove the elephant tooth and the bones. You get good price for them in the market. Come on, go and start your work now.
Sindbad had become an expert hunter now. He hunted at least 1 elephant in a day. But one day...
What's this elephant doing? I will fall down. It will surely kill me today. I think. It won't leave me. I think. Oh, mother, my back. Ya Allah, my waist, my back has gone. What is this? Ya Allah. Okay. When death comes, the elephants go and die on a particular place. And this must be the place. In order to save the life of its other fellow beings, it has shown me this place. Yes. Master, there are thousands of elephant skeletons there. But if you promise me from today onwards that you will not kill any elephant, only then will I show you that place.
Okay. I promise you. And I free you from my slavery as a reward. From now, you are a free man.
I was really very happy for being free from the slavery suddenly like this. And for this, I thanked Allah. And after that, I got on a ship. I reached Baghdad. Now, you only tell me, Sinbad. Am I wrong in living like this, leading a happy life?
Of course not, sir. Only after hardship and troublesome life you have earned this wealth and this happiness. You have got a full right to enjoy this. Now I have understood it well, that you don't get anything in life without troubles and hard work. So children, I hope you too agree with me. So now concentrate well on your studies. You should score good marks in the exams. Outstanding in sports too, isn't it? Because you can also become the 21st century's Sindbad.